Hello, welcome to our weekly Cytonn report segment. My name is Teresia Kingara and I'll be your host for the show. This is a segment whereby we seek to talk about, or on a deeper level, the Cytonn report, which is our authoritative report that goes out every Sunday. With me today on the show is Justa Kendi. Please introduce yourself.
My name is Justa Kendi, a research analyst at Cytonn Investments, where we focus on to carrying out various market research to inform the market on current investment opportunities.
Would you tell us where you normally focus in your research for the real estate segment?
We focus largely on to Africa as a whole. Currently, we have worked on various reports in West Africa, looking keenly into Accra, Ghana. We have added East Africa, where we have covered Kigali, Rwanda, Kampala, Uganda, and Tanzania, that is Dar es Salaam.
Have you featured any cities in Kenya, or you normally focus on the region alone?
In Kenya, we have dived into various key cities and towns. We started in Nairobi, then we focused into Nyeri town. We went to Nakuru town, then Mombasa city. And currently we have been working on Kisumu City.
And what are some of the themes that you normally focus on when you're doing your research?
For the real estate sector, it is divided into various key themes, mainly commercial sector, which can be broken down into retail sector, office sector, and industrial sector. We have residential theme. There we look into apartments, detached units, and combine all of them to get the investment opportunity into that theme. And we also dive into land to look into the capital appreciation. And lastly but not least, we look at the listed real estate. Those are rates. For example, in Kenya we have one listed rate, that is Stanlib iRate.
For those who don't know, perhaps you could tell us more on what rates is and how it works.
Rates are mainly listed real estate. They operate the same as equities, where investors buy into real estate units, into either an income generated development, that is an IRATE, or you can buy into development rate, that is where you buy into a development that is going to be constructed, then you get income once it's done and sold out.
Okay. Your latest report focuses on Kisumu and its performance in real estate. Would you tell us a bit more on what the research findings were?
For Kisumu, we carried our market research in the month of May 2018. Our key focus was across all the themes, commercial, residential, and land. The key factors that we were looking into were prices in the market and mainly identifying the trend. So looking at the past prices, looking at the rent that they're charging, the occupancy rates, the uptake of the developments that are on sale, mainly that what was covered. Looking at the performance, we have analyzed over 2 years, that is from May 2016 to May 2018. The performance remained relatively flat, recording a total return of 16.1, which was 0.6 percent points increase from what was recorded in May 2016, which was 15.5%.
So those figures, what do they mean to the layman? Does that mean Kisumu is performing better than other regions, or does that mean it's performing better compared to 2016? Does it mean there's no change, or what does it mean?
To put it into perspective, what that means is that if an investor puts up a development, whether it's an income generating development, commercial or residential, will be earning a rental yield every year out of the rent that they collect, will be earning a rental yield of 7.2%. And at the same time, the development will be growing at a rate of 8.9%. So that's how they are able to generate a total income of 16.1%. Looking in May 2016, if one put up the same development, they were able to generate a rental income of 7.0%, and the development was growing at a rate of 8.5%. So yes, the real estate sector are slightly improved.
You've talked about an increase in the overall performance of real estate in Kisumu from 7.0 to 7.2. What are some of the factors that have driven this rise in performance?
Kisumu, over the recent years, it has witnessed several factors that has led to increase in performance of the real estate. These factors, we can name a few. First is positive economic growth. The county has recorded an average GDP of $625 compared to an average Kenyan at $634. What does this mean? It means that there's an increase in disposable income and increase in demand for the real estate products in Kisumu. Secondly, it's positive demographics. Kisumu city population is currently growing at a rate of 2.8% compared to Kenyan average at 2.6%. This is therefore increasing the demand for the residential units particularly, and increasing the demand for the same units in Kisumu city. Thirdly, we'll look at devolution. This has attracted key people into the city, such as government institutions, private investors and entrepreneurs, and creating demand for themes such as office and retail, and at the same time for the residential units that these people are living in. Lastly, we'll look at infrastructure development. In the recent years, Kisumu City has witnessed increase in infrastructure development, such as the upgrading of Kisumu Airport into international status, upgrading of slums by the National Youth Service, and some of the roads such as Kisumu-Kisian Highway that is under development.
So somebody looking to invest in Kisumu's real estate, what are some of the themes or areas you tell them to focus and put their money in based on your research?
Looking into our research analysis, I will first of all break down into their performance, then we can dive in as to why we recommend various themes. First, the residential sector, it recorded an average rental yield of 5.1% and a price appreciation of 1.8%. So meaning if an investor gets into that market, will be able to earn a total return of 6.9% in some estates such as Milimani, Mamboleo, Riat Hills, and others. Looking at commercial offices, they recorded an average rental yield of 7.0%. And Kisumu has had Green Sea offices. Those are the old buildings. However, it is witnessing entry of Grade B offices, such as University of Nairobi buildings, of which they recorded an occupancy rate of above 80% in the first year of operation and recording a rental yield of 6.4%. The other thing is retail sector. The sector has grown over the last 5 or so years. Currently, it has recorded a rental yield of 9.4%. Other sectors are land, which is currently recording an annual capital appreciation of 8.9%. So looking at all the sectors, we would look into investment opportunities in residential sector, but with a key target into apartments for rent that are generating a rental income of approximately 5.5% in estates such as Milimani and Mamboleo. The other thing to focus on is commercial offices. Those are grade A and B offices. They're in higher demand, as I have stated, that they have recorded an occupancy rate of 80% in the first year of operation. The other key theme would be to look into land sector. Currently, it has recorded an annual capital appreciation of 8.9%, and there's mass exodus from the central business district as they focus into other areas such as Riat Hills due to congestion in the city. For retail sector, yes, it is recording a high yield of 9.4%. However, we remain neutral on the same given the high supply of the same in the market. To put this into perspective, currently the supply in the city is approximately 149.
In Kisumu City.
Kisumu City. approximately 149 square meters, serving 1,000 persons. Comparing it to other counties such as Nairobi, where we have 145 square meters, serving 1,000 persons, while in county like Kiambu, we have only 45 square meters, serving 1,000 person. So looking into it, clearly there's a high supply in the market, which may lead to a decline in occupancy rates, translating to a decline in rental yield.
We know that there are other areas that the report focus is on, or rather the research focus is on, such as Nyeri, Nakuru. How do these other cities compare to Kisumu's report on real estate?
Looking at the real estate sector, Kisumu recorded an average rental yield of 7.2%. This is mainly lower than other towns and cities such as Nyeri, Mombasa and Nairobi that recorded an average rental above 8.0%. However, it was higher than in towns such as Nakuru that recorded an average rental yield of 5.2%.
So what does this mean to somebody looking to invest in real estate in Kisumu? What does the future look like?
If you are an investor, if you invest in Nyeri, Mombasa and Nairobi, you earn a higher rental yield of above 8.0%. However, if you invest in Kisumu, you earn 7.2%. But at the same time, Kisumu presents an opportunity, of which we have seen there's been a slightly increase in rental yields of 0.2% between 2016 and 2018. At the same time, this market was constrained by prolonged 2017 electioneering period. Therefore, we expect recovery of the market due to the positive economic factors in the year 2018. And thus, having looked at investment opportunities, we have seen the market as pockets of value. And therefore, investors can look into such as residential and commercial offices.
Thank you, Justa Kendi, research analyst at Cytonn Investments, for making time to be with us. Until next time, kwaheri.